Good Erev Shabbos. I hope you and your family well and had a good, inspiring Yom Kippur. A huge thank you to all those who helped to organize our festival services over Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, to Julian Charles and his wardening team, and to Stephen and the board and exec, and also to our security team, and especially to Grant Benjamin, who helped us with a lot of the Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur services. Now tonight, we are broadcasting our Kabbalat Shabbat service with the United Synagogue Television. Please tune in for that. That's at 6:20. Those who are coming to Shul tonight, we are doing Mincha at 6 o'clock. If you're not able to come to Shul, you just want to watch us at 6:20, please do tune in. And that's the United Synagogue TV, so check out their website. So we've just had the festival of Yom Kippur, and this concludes the days of awe. And now we're beginning the days of Simcha, a joy, as we reach the festival of Sukkot, because the ultimate way of serving our Creator is through joy. We have to go through a sense of awe and recognition, but once we've done that, we've gone through Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, and renewing that relationship, now begins the time of tremendous joy. Now this week's Sedra, Ha'azinu, is very short, but it contains the essence of the whole of the Torah. In fact, there's 613 words in the Torah portion of Ha'azinu, representing the whole of the Torah. And Ha'azinu is a song. In fact, last week's Sedra, we had the 613th mitzvah. And that mitzvah is writing a Sefer Torah. And the Torah says, Kitvu lachem et hashira hazot. Write this song. It refers to the mitzvah of writing the Sefer Torah as a song, because really the Torah wants us to serve and to live a life of tremendous joy and emotion and feeling. So as we've now left the days of awe and we go into the days of Simcha, of Sukkot, may Hashem bless us to have days of tremendous inner joy for us and our family and for all of the Jewish people. Shabbat Shalom, and wishing you all well.